ICG has completed 8 years of its inception. During these 8 years, ICG has created new various memories and very successful able members, and some of them have even gone onto a pinnacle of public speaking and confidence. We call them rock stars. Today we meet one of the rock stars. This rock star has reached for the stars in every aspect of her life. I fell in total love with her the first time I ever met her. She's beautiful, charming, and just superb with her speech. If India has Shashi Tharoor, Goa has a Toastmaster Sharmila. Welcome, Toastmaster Sharmila.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sathur.
I would like to first of all say that I have not been a very good student and sorry for all my mistakes.
You're forgiven.
Toastmaster Sharmila, when did your journey in ICG start?
Okay.
Can you remember your first
day? Even before ICG, if I could say something more about my Toastmasters journey, which did not begin with ICG, as a matter of fact. Like I said, my husband said, he joined Toastmasters much before I did. And a quick confession, I hated Toastmasters. The first few years when I came to know of Toastmasters, I hated it with my guts. That's because my husband would only talk about Toastmasters at home and nothing else. Any guest would come home, he would start selling Toastmasters to him. So much so that I had to tell him beforehand, please do not talk about Toastmasters. After a few years, I said, let me see what this is all about. And that's where I started attending a few meetings. And at that time, Mapsa Toastmasters was just getting started. And they wanted members and I joined Toastmasters at Mapsa. 2 years after that, some of the members of ICG, especially Toastmaster Naveen, asked me to join ICG. And that's when I joined ICG and I have never looked back. And I cannot imagine being a part of any other club but ICG club. So that's my story.
It's a wonderful story. Toastmaster Sharmila. I think District 98, your father is famous after District 98 because of your lovely speech. I've seen your mother once and I can say you get your good looks from your mother. Can you tell me how your mother inspired you into what you
are? Alright. If you've heard my speech, I've spoken a lot about my father. That is because I was very close to him, as most daughters are to their fathers. And my mom has been like the background pillar for me. Never there right in front like my father, but more beside me or behind me. And after my father's death, I have learned so much from my mother. The way she lived her life after her husband's death is what I have learned, that I should be as strong as her. So today I can say that if I have the strength to do things, it is because of my mother.
One thing about Toastmaster Sharmila, she is always very humble. I remember my first time when I came, I was so nervous and it was the first speech you gave and I had messed up as usual very badly. And when we went to the break, you asked me how was my speech.
Okay.
And I said, wow, such an accomplished speaker is asking for my opinion. Are you like this with everybody or am I special?
I know you are fishing for compliments. You are of course very special to me, but I must admit that I am like this to others also. Somehow maybe being a teacher makes me like that, where I am looking for the child in front of me to develop. So I look like that to my Toastmaster colleagues also. So every time I come across somebody like you, I feel that I must help somehow or the other. And I know that to make a person feel good, you have to sometimes be a little smaller in front of that person. So that's probably why I ask their opinion for myself. And that's why you felt that, I was trying to be humble, but that's just the way I am.
You definitely made my day.
I'm glad.
Toastmasters Sharmila has reached a pinnacle. She is a principal in a reputed school. She has recently gone a great distance in the international. But what I notice is, you know, even for a small meeting, you always give your best.
That's true.
Where do you get your energy from? What do you eat?
Okay, certainly not what I eat. But seriously, Toastmasters, and this is for all who are listening to me, and for those who say we are so busy with our work, we don't have time to take up roles, we don't have time to be a Toastmaster, this is my message to them. Believe me, Toastmasters is my stress master. Although I have a full day at school and I've got meetings after meetings and I've got parents who can make you go mad sometimes, it's just thinking ki, okay, there is a Toastmaster meeting in the evening, whether it is live or not, I'll be meeting my friends online or real, and I'll be able to share my experience with them and learn from them, is something which keeps me alive and kicking. So that's where my energy comes, just by being a part of Toastmasters. So that's how it works for me.
So next, a very personal question.
Okay.
I know for sure there would be countless of boys, you know, just trying to woo you. You know,
okay.
What did that special one do to be successful?
Okay, fine. This special one, I mean, if you have to talk about persuasion and persuasive powers, nobody can beat the person whom I married, finally. This is a man who pursued me right from when I was 16 years old and wouldn't give up till I was 21. That kind of persuasion is not seen by many people in this world. The moment you have a few meetings and you feel that that person is not giving enough importance to you, they give up and they move on to another person. But this person pursued me till I said yes. He used all sorts of methods. He used some, I know that for a fact, that there were times that he made up stories just so that I would agree to be a part of his life. He brought in instances of other girls who might be interested in him so that I would want to marry him. But the point is that his persuasive powers, and till date, I do feel that that is the one thing that pulled me towards him.
For all you young guys out there,
true.
The one is DTM Umesh. And please get in touch with him.
To learn from him.
So, you're in the pinnacle. What next for Toastmasters?
Okay, again, when you say pinnacle, let me tell you this. This for me was not the important point, okay? I took it up because I wanted my club's name to be. I know I don't want to sound like a martyr, but that's how it was. It was not for my own reasons. It was that my club's name goes higher. That was my main reason for being part of it. But this is not why I am at Toastmasters. I am not here to win contests. I am here to improve myself, and I still feel I am doing that, and also to mentor others who would want my help. And I'm always open about this. Even when I go to other clubs far away, I tell them, if you want to send your speeches to me, if you want to practice with me, please feel free. You don't have to take anybody's permission for that. So I'm here mainly for that. I get immense pleasure when I see a person who was raw in front of me and who has become a good speaker in front of my eyes. That gives me the most pleasure. And that's why I'm here.
So for a new person, you know, who just joined ICG Toastmasters or Toastmasters anyway, what advice would you give?
Right. For youngsters, I feel very strongly that this forum is going to help them in the long run. Today's world is a competitive world. You have to be better than the best. And for that, you have to work hard. Just degrees are not going to suffice. You are going to be, and especially in Goa, we live like frogs in a well. We don't know the real world outside. It's when you step out of school and college and sometimes out of Goa that you see what the real world is, and it is extremely competitive. For that, you have to have that gumption, the confidence to speak in front of anybody at any time on any given topic. And that you can get from Toastmasters. So the youngsters who have joined, whom I know them so well, many of them are students, I've told them that this is going to help you in your career. Maybe it doesn't make any difference to me now, I don't require it, but you guys require it. It's going to make a difference. And I know it has to many of them. So that's my advice make use of this forum that you have. Participate as much as you can in whatever you do, roles or speeches, and you see the difference it will bring into you. And I'm sure the others will agree in what I have said.
I definitely see the confidence in you. And if you guys want to see more of the rock star, Toastmaster Sharmila, do join us on a 200 meeting where you get a good surprise from her.
Thank you.